Let's move on then. Tata Steel came out with its second quarter numbers and it looked very, very good, particularly for the domestic part of their business. Their margins expanded, profitability as well. So a big jump. To understand what's the way forward and how was the past quarter, we have Mr. Narendran, the MD and CEO of the company, who joins us. Thanks so much, sir, for joining in. Well, if you could give us a sense of the sustainable EBITDA per ton, both for the India business as well as the Europe business. In the past quarter, there were quite a few one-offs. So what kind of a sustainable number can the street work with?
So as far as India is concerned, I think we had a very good Q2. It was typically a weak quarter, but we had a good quarter. So I would say the forecast for India EBITDAs would be between Q1 and Q2 EBITDAs. So that would be the range one should look at. Things will go a bit up and down, but that would be a range one is comfortable with. As far as Europe is concerned, again, it would be somewhere between Q1 and Q2. We had a very good Q1, but we had a bad Q2 in Europe, more because of operational issues. The market is strong and been reasonably strong in Europe. We've got better prices in Q2 than Q1, but operationally we had some challenges which we are recovering from. We've had an improvement, some improvement in Q3, and hopefully a better Q4. So I would say between Q1 and Q2 EBITDAs is what you should be looking for the second half.
Okay. There has been some correction in the steel prices in China in the last few weeks. So if you could just throw some more light on that. And what is your outlook on global steel prices from here on in India and globally?
Yeah. So in the last few weeks, yes, there has been some softness in Southeast Asian markets led by what was happening in China, maybe about $30-$40. I think I've always said right from the beginning of the year that the prices should be in the $550 to $650 range, and it's operating in that band. I don't see it dropping much beyond where it is already, because coking coal prices are in excess of $200. Iron ore prices are also quite strong. So the spreads have actually got squeezed in the last few weeks because the raw material prices have not dropped. So I don't think these prices will stay at this level for very long. It certainly cannot drop much further. It will stay at this level or improve, or the raw material prices have to drop. And just now I don't see an oversupply in the raw material space. The Chinese steel companies are buying premium raw materials, and so they're paying more premium for high quality raw materials, and that's adding to the tightness of the market. Macroeconomically, demand is strong in most major steel consuming markets. Even in China, the steel consumption has grown at 7%, and we're seeing a reduction in inventories which was there in the pipeline. So automotive market in China slowed a bit, but most other sectors are reasonably strong. So let's wait and see, and I hope that there will be some resolution on the US-China trade issues.
Mr. Narendran, you know, the Southeast Asian part of the business, that hasn't been doing great. Well, it makes single-digit margins. Would you consider exiting the Southeast Asian business?
We are always evaluating different options, and Southeast Asia is also part of that portfolio evaluation. And yes, it has traditionally been a 5-6% EBITDA margin business. It's overall been a profitable business, but it's been in a region, it is in a region where the demand is quite strong, but there are some structural challenges there as well. But so we're evaluating all possibilities. We'll announce it when we come to that.
All right, quick check on the markets. I think the Nifty has moved to the high point of the day.